ค่ะ
From that old church.
Idiot! Shut up!
Well now.
Bex, I found another anomaly.
Is that what we're calling them?
And another data packet. Should I get it?
If it's anything like the last one, absolutely.
Thank you. note. You injured. Let me see. No. No more, please. Let me die. Here. Rome is quiet.
No. This is not your end. There is a way. A piece of Eden. A staff. Attuned to this message of transfer. It may work.
My lead, like the outcast husband. A beating heart within the mind. Do what you must. I see no other way.
Hey, are you two hearing the same voice as I'm hearing?
Not sure what you mean. It's all quiet on our end.
Damn it. Well, I'm at the second packet. You ready?
I'm ready.
I got the data. Sending it now.
The body was picked clean, and valuables taken. No effort. Guards here are vigilant.
got you!
Feed the crows.
speed on to the old fire. Thor lends me strength.
Help! Someone help me!
Something going on?
Meet your fate.
Thank you.
Swan Road!
No raising the sail here.
Tell the tale of the six Christian missionaries I lured away from their faith into the worship of Almighty Thor?
You showed them how to turn the crosses into hammers, simply by flipping them over. And they fainted with joy. That tale?
Yes. Yes, indeed.
Cannot even weep.
Why the cursing, Vikinger?
These are the funeral embers of the last of my raiding crew. One by one, they have fallen.
It is a heavy loss.
There is more. Just days ago, news from Norway tells me my family has been taken by the plague. All of them. All!
Vikinger.
My wife, my children, all my pretty ones. It is too much.
You must grieve for your loss, friend.
I cannot weep. As a raider, I taught myself not to. Could you give me leave to weep?
What do you mean?
You are a Vikinger, as am I. Perhaps if you gave me leave, I would water the earth with a storm of tears to soften the pain.
We must distract your mind from this sadness. Let us fight a holmgang to first blood.
It is a good idea. I cannot weep, but I can still fight!
It is always good to fight. But friend, it
It did not take away my grief.
Must grow in these waters.
Is there a sea scald among you?
Bring the mast down.
I was the youngest, my favorite cousins. A wild and rowdy bunch of boys and girls. Together with our parents, we attended a feast at the home of Halfdan the Black of the House of Yngling. To toughen our patience, our parents set us with the old woman, who ordered us to bake flatbreads and serve it to the noble jarls. After an hour, the flatbreads piled so high into pillars, you could have built a roof over it. When our work was done, an older boy, Guthrod, suggested we steal a keg of meat, drown in happiness for our good work. So Guthrod, Mikkel, and Åsa snuck into the storeroom.
Can't raise the sail here.
I stood watch. But when we were spotted, I froze. Three of Harald's men stopped us. Struck Guthrod and Mikkel and pushed Åsa to the ground. Whose idea was this? They asked. I stood and said, the idea was mine. The meat is for me. One of the men eyed me and said only, that is not true. Then, they moved on.
Give me a hand!
Come
can't do this alone.
Look here! The spoils of war!
Show me what lies ahead.
Good day, Eivor! Thanks for the good work, Eivor. Got a real little fishery going here.
Are you the man in charge?
It's my grandfather, really. But he says the best way to learn responsibility is by working. Besides, between you and me, I'm better at it. More of a people person, you know?
I do. It's good to have you. Both of you. I brought something for you.
I've heard tell that this one's a real fighter. He must have put up quite a fight. Not even Grandfather has caught one of these. Grandfather will be excited to see this catch.
I must be on my way now. Goodbye.
Goodbye.